Bam, Mr. True.
In this video, we're going to take a look at the dot product and see how it helps us find the angle between two vectors. Now, the dot product is the process of, well, let's see, first you have to have two vectors in their horizontal and vertical components. So here I have vector v, which is a sub 1 times vector I plus b sub 1 times vector j, and vector w, which is a sub 2 times vector I plus b sub 2 times vector j. And I'm using these I and j notations, this horizontal component vector and the vertical component vector, which each have the length of 1, because my textbook stresses that a lot. You might see this in a bit of a shorthand version where it's just a comma b in a set of pointy parentheses, if you will. The dot product itself is found by taking the product or multiplying the two a sub values, a sub 1 times a sub 2 plus b sub 1 times b sub 2. And you just get like this scalar multiple, this numerical value. It alone doesn't necessarily mean a tremendous amount as it stands alone, except for, as you'll see later, and I'll remind you now, that when the dot product is equal to 0, those two vectors are perpendicular. Now, all this arithmetic is just dealing with addition and multiplication. And addition and multiplication are commutative and associative, so a lot of the properties you learn way back in, say, Algebra 1, a lot of those properties apply to dot products as well. The dot product is commutative, so it does not matter what order you do the dot product in. If you're taking the dot product of a vector and the resultant of two other vectors being added together, you can basically kind of distribute that dot product through the parentheses and get vector u dot product of v plus vector u dot product of w. If you do the dot product between the zero vector and any other vector, you will get a value of 0. And if you take the dot product between any vector in itself, as you'll see in this example, that is the same as squaring the magnitude of that same vector. And you do actually have to write that out. The square root that you would see in the magnitude, which is in the distance formula of the Pythagorean theorem, will cancel away with the power of 2. Let me just show you that, actually. So the magnitude of a vector, if it's in component form, is equal to the square root of a squared plus b squared. And then it's the magnitude squared, so that's going to cancel out that square root symbol, giving you the a squared plus b squared I had a second ago. And we have kind of like a combination of associative and commutative property here a little bit with a scalar multiple and the dot product. Let's go through an example. So we have vector v and vector w, and we want to find the dot product, so we're going to take the two values of a, multiply them together, so 2 times this a value of 1, and add that with the b values, and say it's 4 times negative 1, and 2 minus 4 is negative 2, and that's it. You know, as it stands alone, that just ends up being a scalar multiple of negative 2, and we're done. Now, if I take vector v, and I do a dot product with itself, and just say, okay, let's take vector v and find the dot product with vector v. That's going to be the two a values multiplied together. So 2 times 2 plus the two b values multiplied together. And v is being dotted with itself, so I'm using the same a and the same b value. So 4 times 4, and here I've got 2 squared plus 4 squared. Look, see what this is starting to look like? That's a squared plus b squared, exactly what I had over here when I wrote out the magnitude formula. And that ends up becoming 4 plus 16, which is equal to 20. So that's just a couple of quick examples of dot products. It's just a little bit of multiplication and addition. Let's see how that helps us find the angle between two vectors. All right, so here we have the formulas for finding, there's two versions of it. We're going to have these formulas for helping us find the angle between two vectors. These formulas, you probably have a derivation in your textbook, they come from or derive from the law of cosine. And it says that the dot product between two vectors is equal to the magnitude of the first vector times the magnitude of the second vector times the cosine of the angle that's in between them. Now, if we solve that for theta, we're going to divide both sides by these magnitudes, and then to get the cosine function away from theta, we'll have to do the inverse cosine. So this is actually the format that you're going to be using most of the time, which is just you're going to be given the vectors and being asked for the angle measure. And thus, you're probably going to use the one that's set up to equal theta more often than the one set up to equal the dot product. So here we have a couple of vectors, and let's run through this formula. Theta is equal to the inverse cosine of the dot product between the two vectors. So we have 2 times 1 plus 4 times negative 1. That's going to be over the magnitude of v, which is going to be the square root of a squared plus b squared times the square root of magnitude of vector w. Well, excuse me, times the square root of 1 squared plus negative 1 squared, or the magnitude of w. Now, be aware that I've wrapped my negative 1 around with a set of parentheses, and really might not be in a bad habit. I actually usually do. All my substitutions, I'll wrap in a set of parentheses just to make sure I don't make a sign error, because let's remember, there is a difference between negative 1 squared and negative 1 squared. This comes out to be negative 1, and this, because the negative is wrapped in the parentheses, is negative 1 times negative 1, which is positive 1. This just squares the 1. So let's not let our fancy calculators give us the wrong answer, because it understands the difference in that notation. Now, when you get all this typed into your calculator, there really isn't much more to this, depending on just how many times or how many steps you take to get this into the calculator, but it is going to come out to be the inverse cosine of negative 0.316, which comes out to a theta value equal to 108.4. Now, let's take a look at this drawing really quickly and see why we can just trust the number out of our calculator right off the bat, and maybe have a touch, a little insight as to why this formula is derived from the law of cosine. So, let's get a different color chalk here, draw an XY axis, and put a few tick marks out here. Okay, so vector V says that it's 2, 4. So we're going to go to the right 2 and up 4, and I'm placing this on the origin only for convenience. You do not have to have vectors always have their initial point on the origin. Vector W is identified as I minus J, or so A is 1 and B is negative 1. So that vector is right here, a rather short one. And we are finding the angle between those two vectors. This angle right here is what we just figured out to be as 108.4. Well, if we are looking for that angle between the vectors, we have enough information to find the magnitude of V. And indeed, the magnitude of V, let's see here. That's 2 squared is 4. 4 squared is 16, so this length is the square root of 20. And this other vector with just the x, a, and b values of 1 and negative 1 has a length of square root of 2. So if you just got studying the law of cosine, you knew that, now I don't have a full triangle set up, but you knew in the law of cosine that if you had side angle side, if you had two sides of a triangle, and the included angle, you would solve that triangle first, or the first step would be required to do the law of cosine to figure it out. So there you can see that side, angle, side, we were looking for the angle in between those two vectors, and that setup is what we used, or when we used, the law of cosine when solving oblique triangles. One more page. Oh, no, one more comment. The 108. Remember that inverse sine with your calculator will only give you answers between negative 90 and positive 90. Same with tangent. But inverse cosine with your calculator will give you values between 0 and 180 degrees. And we're always going to be looking for the angle, the short way around the circle. You know, when vectors are open up like this, we want the inside angle. We don't necessarily need to wrap around the long way around those two vectors. If we need to know that, we can just take this entire 360 degree rotation and subtract 108 from it. So when you do the this formula to find the angle between two vectors, you are going to be finding an angle that's on the more closed side of those vectors, an angle that is less than 180 degrees, since that's what you get out of your calculator for the inverse cosine, since it has a restriction and so it acts as an inverse cosine function. But if I babble on more, I'm going back to an old concept. So, next screen. Well, if we're finding the angle between vectors, what does it look like when those vectors are perpendicular or parallel? Well, if they're perpendicular, you can stop with the dot product. If your dot product comes out to be zero, then those vectors are perpendicular or orthogonal, as we like to say in vector language. So, what does it look like to be parallel? Well, when you have vectors that are parallel, if the numbers are easy enough like these are, you might notice that they're a scalar multiple of each other. 4 times 1.5 is 6, and 14 times 1.5 is 21. So just the fact that I can see that these are scalar multiples of each other automatically tells me that they're parallel. And all the signs are the same. So I also know that the angle between those vectors is 0, and thus they're going to be parallel going in the same direction. If my signs had changed, then I would have parallel vectors but going in opposite directions. Well, that's all fine and dandy, but what if you can't just glance at it and see that they're scalar multiples of each other? You apply the formula. So we have theta is equal to, once again, the inverse cosine of the dot product between the two vectors. So we're going to have 4 times 6 plus 14 times 21 over the magnitude of V. So that's going to be the square root of 4 squared plus 14 squared times the square root of the magnitude of vector V, which is going to be 6 squared plus 21 squared. Now, again, you can work this out in tiny little pieces with your calculator and show it many steps at a time. I'm just going to give you the final answer. When you get this typed into your calculator, you're going to get the value of, oh, we don't even need a calculator for this, right? I already noticed that these were scalar multiples of each other, and they were going in the same direction. So I hope when we get done, this answer comes out to be 1. So theta equals the inverse cosine of 1, and you won't notice that, you know, begin with, maybe. And if you do notice this relationship, you probably are trying to find the angle between them. And the inverse cosine of 1, well, the inverse cosine of 1, what do you put into an inverse trig function? You put into an inverse trig function, you know, the sides of a triangle, and you get out an angle measurement. So around the unit circle, where's your cosine value equal to 1? Your cosine value is equal to 1. Your x over r value is equal to 1 with a rotation of 0. So, you know, thus again, as I noticed ahead of time, these vectors are parallel and they're going in the same direction. Whereas if I made this negative 4 and negative 14, that would be negative 4 here, negative 14 there. It would be negative 4 squared, and I'm running out of space here, plus negative 14 squared. In my answer, these negatives are going to get squared away anyway, and my top number, instead of becoming positive or being positive, will become negative. And where on the unit circle now is inverse cosine of negative 1? What rotation gives me a cosine value of negative 1? That's going to be at 180 degrees. So that's just a last little step there for your special cases of when your vectors are either perpendicular with a dot product of 0 or parallel. And there's two cases of being parallel. You might want to be able to remember or note which it is. Are they going in the same direction or are they going in the opposite direction? I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.